Okay, sir, so we, the thing has come on the screen, so we have, I think you need to...
No, no, put the computer on the, this one.
So we have a 18-year-old patient who appears in the clinic, general ophthalmology clinic, and was considering laser vision correction. Vision in the right eye, 6x6 with a 5.5 spherical and a one diopter cylinder 180. Left eye also 6x6 minus 6 spherical minus 1.1 cylinder at 180. Otherwise, all anterior segment normal, gonioscopy open, applanation tensions 15 in both eyes, and you see the disc findings. Present. Quite reassuring, didn't look very suspicious, and we would have gone ahead. But for some reason on that particular day, the patient's mother said that, you know, we are worried because we have a family history of glaucoma in the grandfather. And I looked again, and maybe that day I was very particular, and this pointer is not working. But in the right eye, you can see that inferiorly, I felt that there was something suspicious in that disc. So I don't know how many of you will agree. Even when I look at it, sometimes I feel there's nothing wrong. Why did I not just go ahead and put the patient for LASIK workup and do the pachymetry and the topography? But that day I felt that this disc, there was something suspicious, and the mother was very particular. So we went and did what we should not have done in hindsight. We did an OCT. And as you can see in the OCT, it is showing definitely a lot of red areas. And you can see here, actually, the disc parameters are fairly okay. But all the RNFL parameters are outside normal. We also went and did a GCC, which also showed everything abnormal. So then we said we cannot stop at this. We did a perimetry, and perimetry was totally clear. Pachymetry was also totally normal. So now the question to be asked to learned and more experienced senior, Dr. B.K. Nayak, what more investigations should we do? Should we go ahead?
Go behind. Go behind. You want to keep this light?
You want to keep this on? It's okay. So the question which sir has to tell us is what to advise the patient, whether we need more investigations, and very, very important answer is first question, what about the laser vision correction? And I think Dr. Mahipal and leading refractive surgery experts are also there. So can we go ahead and do the laser correction or put it on hold?
Now I will ask one question to each and everybody. Now see, what more investigation? BK, as you know, is an excellent glaucoma surgeon, and also you know the perimetry and OCT is taking the near about 4 hours or 5 hours class non-stop. So I think the BK will be able to tell us ki, as the 18 years age, and in that you can see the OCT is totally red, but the perimetry is normal, the intraocular pressure is normal, there is a history of the glaucoma in the family. So now what investigation you will advise to the delegates? BK.
No, it's one thing that on OCT we have got more almost everywhere, all around, it was showing red. So it just simply signifies that statistically it is not in the normal range. But whether it is glaucoma or something different, that really means it's a, one has to find out. Perimetry is absolutely normal. So far as the disc was disc appearance was there, means just with the close look, it was looking as if in the right eye there was some RNFL defect in that area. And the upper part, there is some kind of defect. But I think if the patient is concerned and the patient is young, plus also having family history of glaucoma, strong family history of glaucoma, in that case, I will say to hold on for doing this surgery and wait for some time and follow it up very frequently. I will also prefer to do, of course, the diurnal variation is, I believe it was not done. So diurnal. Yes, so diurnal variation, I will do that, and then hold on for this surgery and ask patient to do a frequent examination. And in case if also means maybe that I will order for ERG and EOG that there is nothing wrong in the macula, but vision was 6-6. So that way that also can be ruled out, because sometimes that can cause the thickness, the thinning of the RNFL all along, but actually having not a major pathology, maybe a stationary condition. So if you are really worried, then we can do that. But otherwise, I don't think anything else I will suggest.
Okay. So whenever you are asking the patient to come frequent, what the distance, how much? 1 year, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, how frequently you will see the patient?
No, because in this the doubt is there, so means I will probably prefer to see it in 6 months interval, at in least for 2 years, and then if everything is stable, then I can say that, okay, go ahead and do this.
It means the what happens, we call the patients always 1 monthly and like that, but it is not much to worry. You can call the patient 6 monthly. Now, what about the laser vision correction to be advised or put on hold?
So laser is a elective procedure. So you can always do it whenever you want it, and you can always investigate the patient fully, because if you are doing the laser correction, if the patient has glaucoma and there is a suction effect, so what damage to the nerve and all that, and what about the post-operative complications after giving steroids, whether the patient is a steroid responder. So LASIK can always wait, and it can be done at any time. Once you have done the procedure, then you cannot go back.
Is this the first visit of the patient to you?
This is the first visit, but I'll share with you that actually, as Dr. Nayak has pointed out, I have followed up this patient, and I have one more subsequent visit which I haven't put on the
So number one is, I know the age of the patient, 18. Even if everything else was normal, 5.5, if the patient was, this was the first visit of the patient to me, unless absolutely reliable records of the patient was available, because many clinics have 21 as the cutoff age. I myself have it as 18. Provided at least for a couple of years, I have seen stability of the refractive error. So I would definitely wait for at least a year more to do a couple of examinations at 6 month intervals, not only for the glaucoma, but also for the progression of the refractive error, and then subject the patient to any kind of refractive surgery if nothing changes. Secondly, I'm highly doubtful this is whether this is indicative of glaucoma, because there's no fields, is not showing anything. And the RNFL thinning is uniform, almost all around. It's nothing, not segmental. And definitely, I would also have a neurological workup done for this patient to look, see whether we're missing something else. But my recommendation would be to wait for some time, at least a year more, look for both progression of glaucoma as well as refractive error. And if everything is stable, go ahead with the treatment.
Maipal?
So I think just to add a couple of things, I would agree with Dr. Ramamurthy. Until, of course, there is an occupational kind of a situation that the patient is wanting to go into Merchant Navy or NDA or whatever it is where LASIK is allowed, I normally don't do patients which are below, they should be in their 20s. So that is point number one. Now, why are we bothered so much about glaucoma is that there are certain things that happen with laser vision correction. The first thing which Ragini mentioned was that you have an increase in the pressure of the eye when you are making a flap, etc. So the gentlest thing on the eye vis-a-vis the pressure not being increased is a surface ablation. The next to that is smile, because smile gives you the least increase in the intraocular pressure, but when you go on to the intralase, etc., or the suction in the keratomes, the pressure goes high. There are anecdotal reports that it has caused problem, even CRAO, etc. But by far, it does not cause any problem, but that is one issue. The second issue, as you would be aware, is the corneal thickness. And corneal thickness is going to impact the person's lifelong follow-up of the intraocular pressures, if that is. So that needs to be told to the patient as a warning, and you need to tell that particular thing. So that is, as regards the laser, I would wish to defer if there isn't any emergency and do a follow-up and to see whether this is a real glaucomatous change or not. The other investigations, obviously, my answer is I'll refer to Harsh to tell me whether the patient has glaucoma or not. But a couple of investigations that he does routinely is, one is CCT, because the pressures may be normal, but you have that. The second thing he does is he checks the BP of the patient as a diurnal fluctuation on the blood pressure for these patients. And the diurnal variation of the IOP is the other thing that we do. So these are a couple of the things that, but by far, as much as I know, this is a very RNFL thinning all over. So that needs, but typically if there is just some RNFL thinning that he gets at some places, the fields are normal and the BP, diurnal, everything is okay, then he would write no glaucoma. So that's the what my glaucoma person normally says.
Manish, what you have followed?
So I have followed what Dr. Nayak suggested. We have put the patient on a follow-up 6 monthly. We are repeating OCT also. with a disc photograph and a perimetry every 6 months to see what's happening, and he is very happy to wait for 2 years till he crosses the age of 20, then get a laser vision correction, provided all these tests don't show any change over time.
Okay. So I think the take-home message is whenever such a thing appears, don't hurry for any surgery, one. Secondly, don't start the treatment on that day. But don't the patient you will have to follow 6 monthly, and also you will have to see the intraocular pressure, diurnal variation, and also for the LASIK you should wait, and I think the upper limit should be 20 when there is a this refractive error is fixed. That time you can think on this issue. And I think the whatever Manish has done, he is following up the patient, he has not started the treatment, is a correct option. Any question from audience on
Sir,
this case?
I will wish to ask him a question. You said you will follow up the patient if there are no changes, so additional changes. So with this RNFL picture, nothing progressing for 6 months, 1 year, what is your advice to us now?
My advice would be to go ahead with the LASIK.
Go ahead with the LASIK.
And why correctly, do you think? Correctly, what you said is that inform and record that pressure is going to be altered because of the thickness, and check the pressure. Anyway, we are checking so many pressures before the procedure. Check a few pressures after the procedure. See how much in his case there is a change.
Yeah.
And keep all this well documented so that for life he knows that whenever he gets an Goldman pressure check, this little...
So what do you think was the reason in this case to get
so
this?
So what I want to point out is that, you know, the OCT itself, this is called red disease in the parlance that we talk about. And this is really not anything to do with glaucoma, but it shows up all red on the OCT. And OCT, every machine has its own
different
false. And this is because nowadays with the marketing and with the talks and, you know, even... we glaucoma people giving talks on pre-perimetric glaucoma where only what you see on the disc and OCT is important, perimetry is normal, this is glaucoma. So if you follow that principle, this is normal tension, glaucoma already, because there is something in the disc which put a suspicion in Dr. Nayak's mind, my mind also, and OCT is abnormal, perimetry may be normal, but we have to be a little careful before we jump into this kind of a scenario and start labeling patients as glaucoma just
so would
based
you
on
be
OCT.
Would you agree that what Harsh says, no glaucoma, you would also say
yes,
no glaucoma?
Yes, I would entirely agree with what was said.
I think another point you have to drive home is that subsequent follow-up should be with fields more than just the
yes,
high pressure
in the future, after these 2 years are over, we will definitely give the information that this OCT is a misleader in his case.
Yes, your question.
Manish, just one more suggestion. Can this, because this machine means OCT can be tried, means just to see whether this was something with the machine itself, on some one different make of machine.
Next.
And
I will give you this answer in June. He is going to come in June. I'll send him to somebody else with a different machine. Spectralis. Yes, I'll get it done on a Spectralis. Sure.
Yes, Spectralis.
By BOA, October, August, probably I'll have the information.
Okay. And the Spectralis, the advantage is also that the retest variability is the minimum. And plus, you can exactly take the pictures every time at the same location. There is no even slight rotation or shift to one side. So that way, because the change, if it is showing, that will be real.
We'll get it done on Spectralis.
Yeah,
okay.
You.
Your question.
I was saying why the patient came to you.
Yes, sir. That's a good question because you see, as you said, as I mentioned, that glaucoma runs in the family. And a glaucoma expert usually, especially a person like me who has been in practice for more than 20 years now, becomes a family member of most of his glaucoma patients. So even they get a tie, they come to me.
Okay. So you are second case in brief.
He had a very high myopia, so he came to get the LASIK done. I mean, he was very keen. Mostly the people at this age come, whatever may be. And you have done the postmortem of his disease, but you have not looked after the patient. What do you tell? Continue with using your glasses for 2 years and come?
Yes, I told him he can try contact lenses. He can continue glasses. Give me a breather for 2 years. His parents were also very happy that I've given this advice and given him because they also didn't want it done right now. And when I showed him all those red, so parents were very happy. They said, at least now we have a reason to tell him not to do the LASIK right now.
Now the second case in brief.
Yes, two, 3 minutes.
Okay.
So this is a very interesting patient, 28-year-old doctor, was referred for unilateral glaucoma, past history, right eye diagnosed to have vitritis and macular edema 6 months ago, for which a subtenous injection, deposteroid and topical steroids were given, and it was treated, vision recovered very well. The current status is that right eye is already on maximal medical therapy with oral dimox also 3 times a day. And present findings show vision is definitely still 6-6, left eye is normal, right eye shows a normal anterior segment, no active uveitis, nothing there. Gonioscopy is open, of course a few pigments are there because of the old uveitis, pupils are normal. IOP right eye is 45 with all this treatment and left eye is 12. Findings, when you lift the lid and on the, this is the temporal side of the patient, you see this white patch which looks like a scleral graft. We did the OCT which was fairly normal, the visual fields were also fairly normal. So now, what are the management options? Because 45 pressure by any standard is going to damage his nerve today and either tomorrow. And we have already given one by one maximum treatment. And from this is when the patient was referred to me. The charts showed that he had already been on this kind of heavy treatment for the last 1 month already.
When was the injection given?
More than 6 months ago.
More than 6 months? You were showing a lot of this thing. This doesn't.
Yes, but that's exactly why I want to show this case, because that's what I saw. In fact, yes. I did not see. Let me be even more honest, I did not see. Because when I see 45 pressure, we are going to start looking at angles and discs and we don't lift the lid and see everything.
Nee, but when you show the picture, there still appears to be,
yes.
Yeah, it seems to.
Can that's how it looks. And I actually missed it when until the patient came and.
Picture the
patient repeated his history. He said, sir, injection was given.
Yeah.
My assistant had recorded it as an intravitreal in the case paper. Then I had to ask again, is that intravitreal? I looked at his record, it said subtenens, and this is what was there.
Ideally, see, my only thing is that you're saying 6 months, that's a different thing. But ideally, if it is earlier and you have this, you should just remove this first.
BK?
In this given situation, 6 months definitely should, it should get absorbed, but then still it is showing that deposition. So it, the first thing has to be tried is has to be removed and then move forward from there onwards based on the response.
But because pressure is 45, so do you have the luxury of just removing steroid and waiting in case it doesn't come down, or should you do something of these three things which I have written?
No, in that situation probably, no, means it's a, like trabeculectomy with MMC, definitely not in the first go. SLT, anyway, I am against SLT in the seeing eye right from the in the beginning. And AGV.
No, it is SLT, not cyclodiode. SLT in seeing eye only we do.
SLT, yes, SLT can be done. Sorry. Yes, sir. SLT can be, SLT definitely can be done. And then.
SLT doesn't work, I suppose. In
Bombay, no, but then this is the.
KK. So we will be brief because we have got only 1 hour. Huh?
It's an encapsulated steroid depot which is there, which needs to be removed. Remove it, wait for 3 weeks and see how far the pressure comes down. If it isn't, then I think in my case at least I'd straight away go ahead and put an AGV. A 40 pressure is not going to respond to anything else.
Ramamurthy?
No, I'm very surprised that it's 6 months old and still it's there as a blob, because normally it should disintegrate. My first step would be to remove that, excise that area where the injection is, and then subsequently put on maximal medical treatment. Obviously, no treatment has been started as yet, and see whether we can buy some time on medical treatment so that the effect of steroids wears off. And obviously, if it doesn't, then we have to look at a surgical option.
Manish, yes, what's your order?
So that is exactly what we did, and I have not brought that video here because I knew there will be shortage of time. We went and excised that deposteroid deposition which was there, and the patient responded first. The pressure didn't come down immediately, but within 10 days the pressure was very much down and then has remained down. I have still maintained him. This is more than 1 year back. I am still putting one drop a day, but he is maintaining good pressure.